So how does an entire train's length of freshly steaming hot taconite go from a train and get loaded into a massive 1,000 foot ore ship? Well, through the process of gravity belts and some really cool engineering. We'll watch as the 1,004-foot-long Mesabi Miner, a vessel christened in 1977, sits along Canadian National's Dock 6 in Duluth. With a hull depth of 50 feet, beam at 105 feet, this vessel is absolutely massive in length, coming in at 1,004 feet. So how does one go about loading a vessel of such size? Once the ship is secured next to Dock 6 and its hatches opened up, these large booms come down from the dock and are belt-fed loads of taconite. As each portion of the hatches are filled up with a predetermined amount, they'll then raise up, the ship will then shift over, the booms will drop down again, and more taconite will be loaded. When fully loaded, the Mesabi Miner can hold a massive 60,000 tons of taconite. As we fly over the stern of the Mesabi Miner, we can see just how long and large Dock 6 truly is. Standing at 84 feet above the water and at a length of 2,304 feet, this dock is massive in size and scale. It was originally completed in 1918 by the Duluth, Mesabi, and Northern Railway. So far, we've only answered half the question about loading a ship of this size. We haven't seen how the taconite actually gets down to the ship itself. After a loaded taconite train gets down to Dock 6, it'll cut off from the one end, make a switch move, and get onto the other end of its train. This is done so it can pull taconite cars up ahead, and then eventually shove the other half of the train down the dock. After shoving the second set of taconite cars onto Dock 6, two crew members on the dock itself will go car to car, both opening and closing the gates of the cars. They do this so the taconite will drop into the dock and go through a system of belts to either go to the ship or the stockpile. In order to open the gates on the car, a worker is on this little contraption, and you'll see it. Part of it will extend into the car, make a twisting motion, and then about a second or two later, we'll see the taconite disappear into the dock below. The two workers on the dock will go from car to car until the entire train has been unloaded. So what happens to the trains once they are done dropping the taconite down at the docks? They'll put the train back together and storm Proctor Hill, head back to the iron range to get loaded again, and do the same thing day in and day out. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment below what you'd like to see in another video.